Carry Me Home was a pretty fun song to write. I actually wrote it a long time ago. I wrote it in, I think it was probably 2011, and I was on, I think it was an acoustic tour, I'm pretty sure. Yes, it was an acoustic tour, and I was sitting in the back lounge of the bus, and I usually don't write a ton on tour because I feel like it's really hard to focus and to concentrate because there's always a million other things going on. So I kind of figured it wouldn't really pan out to be anything, but I sat back there for like maybe an hour or two and wrote the whole song, and it came out really quickly and it came out really naturally. And I think it was because I wasn't trying. I kind of just assumed it wasn't going to be anything, so I put like no pressure on myself to actually get a song done, and in return I got a song done, and it became one of my, you know, favorite songs I'd written in a while, to the point of where we started playing it really, really soon after, even though no one had heard it. And it's funny because I think more people know that song than some of the songs that are on albums and EPs that have come out in the past, just because of YouTube videos and stuff, and we've been playing it on tour for such a long time. But I'm really excited that it's finally coming out as a real thing, and it's not just a bad quality YouTube video anymore. There's actually three versions of the song at this point. There's the first version that I did in the back lounge of the bus on that tour, and then I did a second version of it with my friend Andrew Goldstein, who produced Give Me Your Hand and some other stuff that I did. And then now I'm on version three, which is the official version that's coming out, the album version. And I did it with Ian Kirkpatrick, who produced the rest of the album with me and everything. So I think third time's a charm. So it's pretty much about a relationship that's ended, and it probably didn't end on very good terms. And you go out to this bar where you know that your significant other, or your ex-significant other, is going to be, and they're going to be with their new friends and their new, you know, maybe their new boyfriend or girlfriend. And you know that it's not a good place for you to go, but you go to it anyway. And you know that it's probably not going to work out for you in any way, but you know what you want. So you kind of almost become a joke at this point as the person who keeps going back. Hopeless, you know, they keep hopelessly going to the bar to really try to make that their big night and really make that the moment that they win back, you know, the girl, and they see this fairy tale ending happen. And it never really culminates as that in the song. It just sort of ends in the same denial that it started with. So I think that's something that a lot of people probably find themselves in at some point or another. Because, you know, you always want to get back what was good in the past. And sometimes it's hard to move on from things. So it's one of those songs for people who just can't get beyond this one person and really still think they have a shot, even though maybe they know they don't. So hopefully that's not you. Hopefully you're in a good relationship spot. But, you know, if you're ever not, this is the song for you.